গুড ইভিনিং এভরিওয়ান। তো মেয়ে রাজশ্রী দত্ত চৌধুরী পরশ পাতার আর্ট ফাউন্ডেশন কি তরফ সে আপ সবকো স্বাগত করতে হু আমারি কনভারসেশনাল সেশন ট্রাভেলক আর্ট আর্টিস্ট এন্ড আর্ট টক। তো আজকে আমারি এই সেশন মে গেস্ট হে অজিত শীল স্যার, যো ইন্ডিয়াকে জানে মানে এমিনেন্ট আর্টিস্ট হে, ওর ডক্টর মেঘালী গোস্বামী যো ওয়েল নোন আর্ট হিস্টোরিয়ান হ্যাঁ। তো এ সেশন শুরু করলে সে পেলে মে থা আমার ইনিশিয়েটিভ পরশ পাতার আর্ট ফাউন্ডেশন কে বারে মে কুছ বলনা চাহুঙ্গি। তো পরশ পাতার আর্ট ফাউন্ডেশন হো এক নন প্রফিটেবল আর্ট ইনিশিয়েটিভ হো মানে ফাউন্ড কিয়া হ্যাঁ। তো মেরা সোচ থা পেলে সেই কি যো আর্ট স্টুডেন্ট হ্যাঁ या आज प्रैक्टिसिंग आर्टिस्ट है तो उनके लिए एक अच्छा सा एक प्लेटफॉर्म हो जिसमें वो अपना आर्ट वर्क अपने क्रिएटिविटी शो कर सके शोकेस कर सके। तो और एक इंटरेक्शन हो कि जो प्रैक्टिसिंग आर्टिस्ट और स्टूडेंट है उनके साथ और एमिनेंट आर्टिस्ट उनके बीच एक पुल बने कि जो एक ब्रिज बने जो एक दूसरे मतलब हम जो इमिनेंट आर्टिस्ट है तो उनके जो आर्ट प्रैक्टिस है उनके जो आर्टिस्टिक लाइफ है उनसे हम लोग कुछ मोटिवेट हो पाए कुछ सीख पाए। तो इसलिए तो ये सब जानना हमारे लिए बहुत अच्छा होता है बहुत फायदेमंद होता है। तो आज हमारे सेशन शुरू होने से पहले थोड़ा सा इंटरेक्शन कर लेते हैं हमारे गेस्ट के साथ।
Ajit Shail is an educator and one of prominent printmakers from India. Mr. Shail at present working as associate professor of graphic art in Kalabhavan Vishwabharati Shantiniketan. Mr. Shail did his studies from Government College of Art and Crafts Assam, then from Kalabhavan Vishwabharati Shantiniketan. Mr. Shail have contributed a lot towards the development of visual arts practice in India through his practice of printmaking. He participated and contributed several national and international exhibitions, artist camps, demonstrations and solo performance in various parts of India and abroad. He has received several prestigious awards from different parts of the country. Mr. Shail's works are in the collection of museum, private collection in India and abroad. Dr. Meghalee Goswami is an art historian and researcher. At present, Dr. Goswami working as HOD in Department of History of Art, Kalabhavan, Vishwabharati, Shantiniketan. She did her graduation in Fine Arts from Government College of Art and Craft, Guwahati, and complete her master degree in Art History from National Museum Institute of History of Art, Conservation and Museology, New Delhi. She obtained her PhD degree in Fine Arts from the Department of Humanities and Social Science, Indian Institute of Technology, Roorkee. Dr. Goswami has contributed to numerous research papers in India and foreign art journal. She has been regularly contributing articles to almost all the art journals and magazines like Art and Deal, Art Fair, etc., published by various publicational houses. Dr. Goswami is also guiding a number of PhD scholar and many of them already has been awarded with doctorate degree as well. Dr. Goswami had authored some books as well. Her latest publication including authored book is Idioms and Images, Printmaker Ajit Shail.
So अभी मैं मैघली मैम को बोलना चाहूँगी कि आप थोड़ा सा कॉन्वर्सेशन स्टार्ट करें सर के साथ, जितसिल सर के साथ। तो मैम प्लीज।
Yeah, thank you, Rajashree, and I thank Porushpathar Art Foundation for coming up with such ideas. And I believe like this will really help the young artists, the new generations to look at the visual art world, because now we know we are in a situation where there is a everywhere like a, there's a lockdown and pandemics going on, but then work must go on and we have to go ahead with our work. We cannot stop. And you have taken a very good initiative, to have a kind of a discussion online where at least like even though the whole world is under lockdown, still there are some ways by which we can look at the artwork, look at the world around us, and the progress should go on, And before like I discuss or we both discuss with Ajit Singh sir, I think I would like to show some of his images
हाँ
and
श्योर मैम।
yes, and then which like I would just talk a little bit about his images, because I have been working with him and I have been seeing his work for quite a number of years, and I must say that I have I was fortunate. I'm fortunate enough to see his work from a very young age when I was like doing my when I was young as a graduate, when I was doing my bachelor's. From that time, actually, I was looking at his artwork, and of course, till now, there are enormous changes in his art. And as you have rightly, titled it as Travelogue. You know, his work goes very well with it, because his life's or he was born in Guwahati, we know, and then how I mean, from one stage to another, he has come across, and he's experimental with the new ideas, new form in printmaking is really to be noted. And I must say, I can say very confidently, he is actually one of the most renowned traditional printmakers in India, because slowly we will in future, I mean, I don't know how much we can preserve this form of art, because now new mediums, new art forms are coming, but there are some very few artists, handful of artists who are still working with the old school or traditional school of printmaking, and he is one of them. Where we can still see his works, I mean the printmaking works from print lithography, then also in plate lithography, I mean then of course in etching. So he's still experimenting with the traditional form of artwork. And as I think you would also want me to show some of the visuals. I mean I'm just trying to show some of his works which I had documented during these few days for this program. As I was discussing that, I during his I mean after I joined Shantiniketan, I was always documenting his work, and I was seeing his process, the way he is working on. And I would like to show 1 sec. So I was like fortunate enough, or I am still fortunate enough to look at his work, the way he goes through the entire process of printmaking in various mediums like wood carving, then litho, and then of course plate lithography, etching. And I'll show you the slides one after another, where like yes. So he has experimented with various mediums, as I told you. So at the very first glimpse of Ajit Singh's work, we become aware of his storytelling, which I really feel that he has a kind of storytelling process in his work. They verbalize his thoughts and beliefs with the help of strong narratives. He reflects his purest being in a true spirit. His works reflects his idea of synthesizing the human and the mythical beings, because these are one, some of the few wood carvings and which I mean I wanted to show in this program. And here you can see that what actually I want to say, where he uses the it's a long laborious process of printmaking which he actually goes through. And it reflects the silhouette of his inner self. His works actually communicates through these semi-figurative creations, and the normal experience of self-incorporation and the fate that one's identity is made up of a body or thoughts, feelings, ambition, plans, ideas, values, desire, action, quality, and so on are all like, you know, expressed in his work of art. And most of his work embodies a bonding of mankind and humanity and the journey of the artist from one face to another. Here, why I'm saying one face to another, because after this few slides I show, we will definitely interact with Ajit sir. And there we'll come to know his journey from how he started from Guwahati, then how he went to Delhi, then from there back again to Guwahati as a teacher in the same institute where he was a student. And then from there, again, he comes back to Shantiniketan, where he was a student during his master's, where he completed his master's. And then from there, now he is a faculty. So his whole journey as a teacher, as a student, and his experiments with the work and his experience as an artist are really reflected in all his works. Like, you know, and so Ajit Steele, through his work of art, approaches and presents a traditional and spiritual morality into visual perspectives. But he is not a thinker in context to philosophy and his approaches as an artist. This is what I feel. His works emerge from personal quests, and for which the most suitable medium he actually feels, or he feels that he can express his self, I quote here as self, is lithography, etching and plate lithography. And his work progress goes with the flow of his thoughts. Sometimes ideas emerge gradually through the mundane life he's enveloped in. At other times, he has undergoes through a long thinking process for days before he starts exploring his visual concept. So these are, you know, I have shown all, you know, not only the new works which he is working, I'm trying to also show the, you know, old works also, the previous works, because here you'll be seeing that how the changes are, you know, shown. And I must also say that when he was in Assam, he was like influenced by the Assamese traditional form of art and the manuscripts. And he took up elements from there, you know, and these elements were reflecting in his work. You know, and you can see by the attire which is shown in his images, then the animals which he uses, then the postures of the images are almost similar with that of the, you know, the miniature or the, oh, sorry, the manuscript paintings of Assam. Here again, because why I'm talking about is if we see this image, we can see that there is a pure reflection of the manuscript, Assamese manuscript painting, where the attire of the human form or the icon which he has titled reflects. He actually, when I was conversing with him, he told me that this actually was an icon of Lord Krishna. So where the entire attire was shown, which was actually the reflection of the Assamese manuscript, even for the postures, because if someone has come across the Assamese manuscript, it is like, you know, we can see that most of the images are in profile form, and then they are, you know, painted with elongated eyes. So these are some of the, you know, characteristics which can be seen in his works also. Then this is, of course, a very contemporary work, very recent work, where this form of work, we can see that how there is a huge change from when he was in Guwahati, when he was initially starting his work, and now at this time, where he had again started using the images, but now he has also started using elements which are which were very much new to him, like in the previous artworks, we didn't find the swan or the peacock or butterflies, these images. But in the earlier works, you'll be in the new works. But in the earlier works, you'll be finding only images of the tortoise. You know, which actually again he wanted to use an element which reflects the kurma, or the one of the avatars of Vishnu. Yeah, and here again, this is also another new work which I wanted to show. Here again, if we look at, we'll find that the elements which are here are again very contemporary, and then the image where he is using a bird, you know, that's again very new. And his works actually expresses that the most important kind of freedom to be what you really are. There cannot be any large scale revolution until there is a personal revolution on an individual level. I feel so, you know. So it must happen from inside, that freedom to feel oneself in what his images speaks. Then it is obvious that while portraying the images, he comes across different personas, and then the life world, you know. Since Ajit Sir's earliest day till the recent work, he's largely involved with figurative works, which is where human and animal, you know, forms easily coexist, you know. So we can see that human and animal forms really coexist in a very well way, and almost co-inhabited in lust. Almost co-inhabited in lush frames of foliage, and human relations, forest narratives, then the forest, the narratives of animals. These are some of the elements we'll be finding in almost all his images here, which I was talking about, the use of the kurma or the tortoise, which he wants to represent as Lord Vishnu, is reflected in this image. And for his works, artworks, I feel, is different in different mediums such as lithography, plate lithography, etching, woodcut, always tries to find a wider space to contemplate his past experience through lines, rubbing or depicting or merging the space which are always within him. Then application of colors, because I'll be showing you some of the paintings also, along with his printmaking. He also does a lot of paintings on acrylics on canvas, acrylic on paper. So all these actually, this application of colors, layer after layer, you know, merges the images to realize the new or to build a new one. Now he believes in, sometimes when I converse with him, he always talks about time. So he believes in time, which actually I'm quoting here, about the past, the present, and the future. For him, history is the frame of vision, he says. So when I was talking about lines, these are some of the images where the reflection of the domination of lines are seen here. And for him, he also has been carrying with him subconsciously in his mind and evolve to a new perspective, sprouting a new visual medium. Now here we can see that he has also done immense work on enamel painting also. And his work speaks a lot to the addressers and bring them to realize his existence. Here once more, we can trace the blend of his, we can trace the blend of how he uses the lines, the forms, the amalgamation of the flora, the fauna with the human form. And according to what I see in his image, the process of image making, is somehow like acceptable, because he also debates the autonomy of certain art versus the interrelationship and the interdependence of the art, which needs to be viewed from the perspective of the art, which are bound together as emerging from a shared worldview and a shared aesthetics. You know, so these are very interesting works where you can see the images. This is again a work where you can see that it's an enamel painting. Of course, it's recent work. Yes, and again, when I was talking about the blending of the, you know, human images with that of the flora and the fauna, this one is a very good example where we can see this. And his works of art presents, I feel, a metaphysical foundation, such as space and time, which he explains by the use of different elements. And this is another work of his. It's a lithography. It's a very huge, you know, where it's a triplex, I think, where you can find the three images. And he has termed, yeah? Yes, sir? Ajit, sir, do you want to say something?
No.
Yeah, so, you know, yeah, this reflects, again, I would like to say that here, again, we can see the reflection of his past, from where he has come from, and how he has blended in a contemporary manner. And this is another plate lithography. So, you, as I was talking about the colors, it's like so very clear that, you know, he actually uses the color plate in such a way from a distance, we really don't feel that this is actually a lithography. It looks like it is a, you know, painting. And that is where he's really having that dominance, I can say, which it's very rare in other printmakers, or I should not say, but the way he has, you know, use the colors in his palette or in his plate lithography is well, it really should be acknowledged. This is another plate lithography where, like, you can see again how he has blended you know, the both the life world, you know, of the mankind along with the nature. And the human faces, like we are seeing all the faces which is trying to, you know, show the human faces as are as much subtle personas. And most of us, we are alert about the way he is using the facial characteristics. And his series of artwork focus on the expression of one's consciousness, which he portrays through his work of printmaking. And most of his subject matters are images recalling the serene facial expression. You know, his facial points lies in the different eye expression, communication, and the body gestures. And his artworks do not only express the desire, pain, agony, and suffering, but also, you know, the pleasure and passion. Most of the images portray illusion, like prevent from revealing the real you, you know, what I feel. You know, sometimes there is always a hidden story to what he really wants to express. And this actually is my personal favorite, if someone really wants to know. It's titled as Paradise. And this is another, you can see the size, which is mentioned 100 centimeters into 140 centimeters. So it's a huge, you know, it's a very large plate lithography. And here again, you can see the blend of both the world, where you can see the peacocks, the peahens, then the image of the women's on the other side. So there is always a kind of illusion, a kind of, you know, revealing the real self or you can say, and to prevent the recognition of the true identity or characters. Because there is always a question, like whom does he want to portray or what does he want to say? It's always there, and there is always a kind of, you know, somehow I feel he prevents the recognition of the true identity or the characteristics. And the image conveys a message of, course, positive pretense. This is again another one, lithography, which I wanted to show. Then along with it, I told you that he also had done a number of, he actually does paintings also. So these are few works of painting which I want to show, where he expresses that, and I mean his works expresses that the most important kind of freedom is to be what you really are, you know, I feel like that when I look at his work. There cannot be any large-scale revolution until there's a personal revolution or an individual level, you know? And so these are some of the paintings which actually I wanted to speak on. And you know, when we look at the paintings, it actually, the figures and the images reflects on his print mediums also. These images are also seen in his print medium works. It's not that something, a new, you know, subject matter he has taken up. He has, the subject matters are all same, but the mediums are actually different. And for him, the totality, I feel, of one's visual expression is more important, what he actually keeps on talking about. And the plasticity of his paintings suggests that he does not feel provoked to make a social comment through his work, you know? And even environment also plays a very important or prime source of his inspiration, because from where he has come, how he grew up, where he, you know, where he studied, and the places which he had changed, or the travels during as an artist, and where he is now. So, you know, the environment also plays a very important role when in his art, you know, which is actually reflected in his artwork. And where actually he is very close to nature. If we look at some of the works, we can find out that he's very close to the nature, and thus find it easier to respond to the work of art on a theme which he can readily identify himself with, such as I told you, landscape, portraits, birds, animals, flowers. But he, you know, he does not stick to only one style, though he's an experimental artist and experiment with many different forms, concepts, techniques, and styles. And he makes a visual poem with different forms. It is rather true how the form of art has an artist, you know, it is actually true how the artist showcase reflects his temperament, you know, his mood, his temperament, and this, you know, also how actually the entire, till now, the way he had traveled from one place to another, and the way he had experimented with his artworks are actually reflected in all these works of art. You know, so Rajeshri, these are some of the works which I wanted to look upon, and I wanted to show you. After that, I think you can start conversing with Ajit Seel sir, and I think after this, I think you'll be followed by one exhibition also of his, right? Yes. So I think Rajeshri, I'm requesting you to now please continue. You know, conversation with him. Of course, I'll also join in between.
Okay, ma'am.
Yes.
Thank you, Marilyn.
So, sir, thank you, sir. Thank you. आपसे मुझे कुछ question है कि जो पहली question तो है कि आपकी जो एक journey है. आर्टिस्टिक जर्नी है आपकी, आपने वो जर्नी हमसे थोड़ा शेयर करेंगे तो बहुत अच्छा लगेगा.
सी व्हेन आई वाज अ स्टूडेंट इन स्कूल लेवल,
यस सर,
दैट टाइम आई डोंट नो व्हाट इज आर्ट, व्हाट इज ड्राइंग, एज बिकॉज़ that time our school a drawing teacher, his name is Subhash Chakraborty.
Achha.
He always learned to how to drawing, how like he draw a drawing blackboard, after that we have take copy this board. So that time that sir always encouraged me and always beech mein bhi humne copy karke bhi leke aate the calendar from calendar and other things, calendar magazine. So he said always very good, very good. So I inspired that. After the school after the school level, I feel I need a formal training. So I took the admission Government College of Art and Crafts, Guwahati, from 1974. After my complete my diploma course, after 5 years, I am at that time. Accidentally, unfortunately, there is some government, Assam agitation is starting. So I feel I need to study again. Next time I come back to Delhi and meet renowned artist Bhavesh Sanyal. He told me to join Gari Studio, Lekala Studio under Devraj Dikoza. So I started from that time. I know what is graphics, what is etching, what is lithography, what's linocut. So gradually I improved this medium. After that, again 1981, I come back again Shantiniketan for higher study. I finished my post diploma from Kala Bhavan. That time our teacher is Somnath Thor, Chanatkar, Lalu Prasad Rao. Another teacher is Shantanu Bhattacharya. So that period, when I got a scholarship from under Somnath Thor, national scholarship under Somnath Thor, at the same time. Our principal Shubhavarma, Government School of Art Crafts, Shubhavarma principal said me, give a letter, you join a Government College of Art and Crafts and start a printmaking department. So, iske baad maine wahan pe jaake fir dobara स्टार्ट किया है 1984 में मैंने गुवाहाटी आर्ट कॉलेज में ज्वाइन किया था. फिर इसके बाद 2007 तक मैंने वहाँ पे अप टू 2007 मैंने वहाँ पे काम किया था. इसके बाद फिर कलाभवन में स्टार्ट टीचिंग एज ए असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर. आई कैन ज्वाइन शांतिनिकेतन. दिस माय शॉर्ट जर्नी. Okay. Till now, I am working in Shantiniketan.
और सर आपसे हमें ये भी जाननी थी एक कि जो हमारी जो अभी प्रिंट मेकिंग की एक तो मैनुअल प्रोसेस है जो हम लोग लिथो एचिंग वो वगैरह करते हैं, तो अभी आगे है डिजिटल मीडियम. तो सर आप अभी एक आ गया डिजिटल मीडियम, एक आ गया है कि हम डिजिटली भी कुछ कर सकते हैं, तो इसके बारे में कि ये कितने फायदेमंद है या वो कितना इफेक्ट कर रहा है हमारे वो ट्रेडिशनल प्रोसेस में, ये आपके कैसे
लगते हैं? एज अ प्रिंट मेकर आई ऑलवेज वेलकम न्यू मीडिया. एट ए new media and new technique is the in the contemporary art scenario. I also welcome the process of digital print, cyanotype, photography, etc., which can be superimposed on litho, stone, etching, zinc plate, and the medium. So actually I feel that every printmaker, actually traditional printmaker, always traditional printmaking, how to this technique, always then you use the new media first to adopt the new old tradition printmaking. After that, you take new media, experiment with new media. Okay.
Or sir, yes ma'am.
Yeah. I want to also, ask sir, how has been your experience in Shantiniketan as a faculty and as a student? As a student, you have already told Rajashree about it, but as a faculty after joining, how was your experience or how is your experience till now? And your relationship with your, students, that's actually what I really want to know.
When I was a student of Shantiniketan that time, that is experience is another thing. Now, when I joined as a faculty, that is another experience. So, this is my challenge, how to, as because Shantiniketan is a world recognized university. So this is for challenging more for me. So I think always try to work in especially with the student and teachers in the studio. Okay. And this challenge for me, but not only reflected my this. I was worked regularly. So regularly work in the studio from morning to evening. Always I carrying with student and. कभी कभी ऐसा होता है जो यहाँ पे आने के बाद आई फील जे हम कहाँ पे आ गए. गुवाहाटी आर्ट कॉलेज में थे, वहाँ पे तो फैसिलिटी नहीं थे, फिर यहाँ पे इतना फैसिलिटीज, इतना वाइडली यहाँ पे काम कर सकते हैं, कोई बाउंडिंग नहीं था. तो इसके बाद मैंने जर्नी यहाँ से दूसरी एक जर्नी में चला आया था. फिर इसको आगे जाके रेगुलरली हम यहाँ पे स्टूडियो पे काम कर सकते, क्योंकि एज बिकॉज ग्राफिक प्रिंट मेकिंग स्टूडियो इज ए कम्युनिटी प्रिंट मेकिंग स्टूडियो. यहाँ पे सिंगल एक आदमी काम नहीं कर सकते, जॉइंटली काम होता है. दिस इज कम्युनिटी स्टूडियो. स्टूडेंट के साथ काम करते हैं, वो सबका साथ मिलके काम करते. स्टूडियो ऐसा चीज है जो जहाँ पे रेगुलरली जाके काम करने पड़ते. जैसे पेंटिंग में क्या होता है, पेंटिंग में जाके अपने स्टूडियो में बैठ कर अकेला काम कर सकते हैं, लेकिन यहाँ पे ऐसा नहीं है, क्योंकि यहाँ पे जरूरत होता है मशीन, सब कुछ जरूरत है, टेक्निकल पार्ट भी यहाँ पे इंक्लूडेड है. तो मैं फिर यहाँ पे आके जितना फैसिलिटी मिला है मेरे को काम करने के लिए और स्टूडेंट के तो उसे उनको सिखाने के लिए जितना फैसिलिटीज मिला है मेरे को, तो गुवाहाटी आर्ट कॉलेज में इतना नहीं मिला. और नेक्स्ट.
हाँ, एक्चुअली अनदर थिंग इज सर, आई मीन व्हेनेवर आई लुक एट योर वर्क, लाइक आई मीन कैन आई से दैट लाइक अजीत सिल कैन बी क्रेडिटेड विद प्रमोटिंग द प्लेट लिथोग्राफी प्रोसेस इन इंडिया, बिकॉज आई हैव सीन दैट यू आर. यस.
See, when I joined the Kolhapur, and everywhere knows me very well, and I started plate lithography in 1994-95. So I started from plate lithography. I learned from Debras Dikosa. His studio, studio name is Atelier 222. So that time, I learned the plate lithography technique. After that, when I was started in Guwahati Art College. After that, I joined here. I regularly work in plate lithography, and always I demonstrated another institution like Rabindra Bharati, Maharashtra, JJ School of Art, Pune, and several college invited me for as a demonstrator.
And what do you think about the other young artists or the young, yes, are the young artists and the young generation still accepting the plate lithography, or they are going or they are taking up some again new mediums, or are they still students or still new budding artists who really are interested in plate lithography, because you have been experimenting with it, and also you have visited many places, many art colleges for demonstration. So how do they take up this subject or this medium?
See, many students learn about the plate lithography. When I go to demonstrate the another college, so many students are participate in this plate lithography workshop. But see, suppose 40 students at a time work at the same medium, I think 4 to 5 is they have adopt this medium, as because sometimes material is the main thing. Suppose we have a plate grinding machine in Kola Bhavan. When I go to Rabindra Bharati University, they don't have any plate lithography machine, plate grinding machine. So always student grain commercially on market, commercially grain it. After that, they use an actual plate lithography. This plate is basically aluminum plate. This is available from market. Another thing, there is, suppose when one student think about the litho, first time doing a stone grinding, this is the main hazard of the stone grinding and final grain, everything. So they are very difficult to process the lithography, and plate lithography is separate issues. You always suppose you grain with market, grain from market plate, and purchase from market, and you directly work with it. Two kind of plate is available. One is normal manual MF plate, that is called MF plate, and the PS plate. Suppose when you use in through computer from exposed plate, you print out this sign called for plate three plate, at for CYMK, this is the computer process and CYMK process. So color plate. At the time you use in four plate. First you take red, yellow, red, blue, black. There is a four plate is there. So at a time you take one. So this type of plate को हम लोगों ने जब photograph PS plate में easy है जो expose करके काम के expose करके हम लोग काम कर सकते हैं. फिर आगे जाके उसका थोड़ा सा इफेक्ट अलग सा होता है. अगर मैनुअल प्लेट में हम काम करते तो उसमें अलग सा होता है. एंड वन थिंग, देयर इज अ डिफरेंट फ्रॉम लिथोग्राफी वी यूज इन स्टोन, लिथो स्टोन, एंड हियर दिस इज मेटल प्लेट. सो लिटिल मोर डिफरेंस, हाँ, as because stone is adopt Greece. Say it is not out of the Greece. We create a layer, this layer, one film coating. After that, I will take the paint. So it is manual labor is less manual labor from lithography.
So do you think that like somewhere the traditional lithography process is facing a challenge at this point
of time? Definitely.
Why do you feel so? Is it because of the material availability or because it is more of time taking? I think you'll know it better. So I want to know more about that.
So see, traditional printmaking, more challenging printmaking medium. Lithography, lithography and plate lithography. There's two mention is two lithography. Litho stone is separate. Litho means stone. When I stone a prepared a stone, they have a take time. After that, we manually labor. Again, you work and time taking. There are 2 days, 3 days to take time. Suppose plate lithography. Suppose you drain a plate, you draw an image. Within 1 hour, you take the finish your work. That is possible. This is a variation, but lithography is always challenging. Lithography always challenge, as because when I draw, sometimes we don't get it same type of luminance, as because situation is weather is hot. So many causes is there, technical.
So
part.
There are many factors, no? Many factors
in, as because yeah. Suppose when temperature is very hot, so stone is adapt the hot, it adapt the heat. So it will. So when I roll the ink, that time totally scum is coming. Is stone is fill up, but technical part is very important for lithography.
And this is my last question. Then I'll just ask Rajeshri to continue. The question which actually I am really interested in. I mean, if you can, you know, talk something about your color palette, which I really, it's really impressive. So if you can say something about that. Then, of course, I'll pass it to Rajeshri. She can continue. Yeah.
The color plate, color is, suppose I take first one color, that is yellow color. When I work for only using yellow color, I prepared a yellow color.
But is it like preconcept? I mean, preconcept or like, you know, it just comes like when you're working. The colors which you use, do you do you have a preconcept notion in your mind that I'll be using only these colors, or it's like it changes while you're working? Okay.
It is already changes. Suppose I think this I need a yellow color, but when I use the color, sometimes different. Sometimes I go to the yellow color. I feel yellow color. Then I use it. Not necessarily. I feel continue. So, as I can make it. क्योंकि हम कभी कभी सोचते हैं ऐसे ऐसे कलर होंगे, लेकिन उसको कलर प्रिपरेशन पे जाने के बाद वो अलग अलग हो जाते हैं. क्योंकि व्हेन आई टेक द येलो कलर, समटाइम्स आई फील द इट इज आई यूज इन नेक्स्ट टाइम नेक्स्ट कलर आई यूज इन ब्लू. दैट मीन्स ब्लू एंड येलो कॉम्बाइन इट इज लाइक ग्रीन इफेक्ट. सो ये सब छोटा 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 जो चीज है, कलर इमेज को अपने अंदर में रखना है, क्योंकि वो कभी कभार हमने जो सोचता है वो नहीं होता है. जाके वहाँ मिक्सिंग होके अलग से इफेक्ट आता है. सपोज आई येलो के ऊपर हम रेड जब यूज करते हैं, तो उसमें जाके थोड़ा ऑरेंज इफेक्ट है, वो रेड प्योर रेड नहीं रहता है, वो थोड़ा सा मिक्स हो जाएगा, क्योंकि एज बिकॉज बैकग्राउंड इज येलो. तो इस टाइप का काम होता है कभी कभी. और इसमें बड़ा चीज है, जो हम लोगों ने जो प्लेट जो लिथो करते हैं, कभी कभी हमने लिथो का सिस्टम ऐसा है कि कभी हम एक कलर एक ही बात एक कलर लेते हर हर कलर के लिए हर वर्ड काम करने पड़ते हैं, ऐसा नहीं है एक साथ में हम हर प्रिंट ले सकते हैं, ऐसा प्रोसेस नहीं है। येलो के लिए येलो एक बार इमेज बना के लिए, फिर नेक्स्ट रेड के लिए रेड, ब्लू के लिए ब्लू, हर टाइम हमको यूज करने पड़ता है, जो जो जिस कलर चाहिए उसी इमेज को हमको प्रिपेयर करना पड़ता है, अदरवाइज मिक्सिंग। हाँ ऐसे भी हो सकता है, सपोज आई प्रिपेयर्ड ए वन ड्राइंग ऑन लिथ स्टोन, उसका आई एम टेकिंग फ्लैग येलो कलर, आफ्टर दैट आई स्क्रैचिंग दिस कलर, नेक्स्ट स्क्रैच द येलो येलो कलर, one after one I take the color. That is possible. That is another technique. And you can also use in separate stone also. So many techniques there. Main first thing, artist should know, should learn the technique. After that, you handle it the medium, with medium. That's main important. Okay.
So this is a kind of message you also want to give the, you know, upcoming artist.
Yeah, yeah, definitely.
Yeah, Rajasri, I pass it on to you now. You can ask, sir.
Okay, ma'am. Sir, मेरे भी एक last question है, तो मुझे instantly एक दिमाग में आया वो question कि वो जैसे हम artist है, मैं भी practical field से ही हूँ, तो मेरा एक क्वेश्चन रहता है कि हम आर्ट से कुछ कैसे लेंगे, और किस कुछ आर्ट को तो कुछ हमें देना भी है, आर्ट का सोसाइटी को, इस आर्ट को, तो कैसे दे हम, मतलब कंट्रीब्यूट कैसे करें
आर्ट के
थ्रू, आर्ट
मैसेज 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 करना है ना।
हाँ ऑब्वियसली
आर्ट को आप कैसे कंट्रीब्यूट कर रहे सोसाइटी में डिपेंड करता है तुम्हारा आर्ट कैसा है, कैसे आर्टी लोग इसको ले सकते हैं, एडॉप्ट कर सकते हैं। देखो कभी कभार एब्स्ट्रैक्ट आर्ट सोसाइटी में इतना इफेक्ट हो जाता है, हर चीज देखने जाओ तो कोई भी चीज हमको उस आर्ट को, आर्किटेक्चरल ड्राइंग जो है वो थोड़ा एब्स्ट्रैक्ट कर सक जा रहा है ना, mainly stop straight line, when you draw the straight line and basic square shape, तो उस टाइप का ड्राइंग कभी कभी मैसेज हो जाता है। वो सपोज सिटीस्केप, आपने सिटीस्केप बनाया, वो मैसेज हो रहा है, सिटीस्केप जाके आर्किटेक्चर के लिए इफेक्ट होता है, उसको गार्डन, उसको सिटीस्केप, उसको कैसे सिटी बनाना है, इस टाइप का मैसेज हर तरीके हर काम में जाता है। अभी हर चीज को हमेशा मैसेज देना भी जरूर नहीं है, कभी कभी आर्टिस्ट नीज ओन सेटिस्फेक्शन के लिए काम करते हैं, ठीक है, मैं अपने लिए काम कर रहा हूँ, वो आप जाके उसको कैसे उसको अपना अंदर लेके अपना क्या मैसेज आ रहा है वो आपका ऊपर डिपेंड करता है, वो मेरा रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी कभी कभी होता है कभी नहीं होता है, वो डिपेंड करता है, ऐसा नहीं है हमको हमेशा आर्ट हम खुद अपना लिए कर रहा हूँ, मेरा मैसेज सबका लिए जा रहा है, ठीक है, जो व्यूअर है वो दिखता है, दिखने के बाद उसके पास अपने आप वो मैसेज हाँ मैसेज अपने पास चला जाता है। जैसे काम देखे लैंडस्केप जो देखते आ रहे हैं कितना सुंदर रहा है, वो ये मैसेज तो अपने पास वो ले रहा है ना,
ऐसे थैंक यू सर, थैंक यू मैम, तो हमारे ये कंटिन्यू रहेगा, एक एग्जीबिशन ट्रैवलॉग वन नाम के जो सर के जो वर्क को लेके हम लोग एग्जीबिशन भी कर रहे हैं, तो ये इसकी थोड़े देर बाद ही हम लोग अपलोड कर रहे हैं और आप देख पाएंगे सर के वर्क, तो वही मैम।
Yes, thank you. Thank you so much, Rajasri. And I once again thank the Art Foundation.
Thank you.
You know, and I wish you all the best. Yeah.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, sir. Ajit Sil, sir, for giving your valuable time for this discussion and making us more aware of this printmaking subject. Thank you, sir.
Thank you,
ma'am. Thank you, sir.
Bye.